Hey, what's up, you guys? Coach Cody, and I want to talk to you a little bit today about the kettlebell swing. So this is just often an exercise that people overlook and they oversimplify it, but there are some key things that we want to pay attention to when we execute on this. So first and foremost, let's talk about stance setup and what the exercise is intending to do, right? So number one, when I like to have people set up with a kettlebell, I like to equate it pretty similar to a squat stance, right? So your feet should be about shoulder width apart. You can toe out a little bit if you would like to. But obviously that's gonna change depending on how tall or short you are, but basic setup is gonna be about shoulder width apart. From there, we wanna think of this exercise as a hinging exercise, right? So a lot of times I'll see people do a kettlebell swing and actually turn it into a squatting motion, right? Where every single time they come down, kettlebell goes really low and they end up squatting it down. But we wanna think that this is a hinging exercise. So when we are setting up and we are in the bottom of our hinge with our feet shoulder width, we want to be in a position to where our knees are under our hips and then our hips are under our shoulders, okay? That way, every single time that I stand up, I want to squeeze my butt and send my head straight up to the ceiling, okay? Another thing to think about when I am swinging the kettlebell back between my hips is think about a simple triangle, right? With my feet at shoulder width, I've got a point of the triangle at my knee, my opposite knee, and then of course at my pelvis. Now every single time I come back with a kettlebell, I want the end of the kettlebell to swing right in the center of the triangle, which would also help you to keep into that good hinging position as well, okay? So to get this kettlebell swing started, a lot of times I often will see people, they'll stand, they'll do a couple motions first, and then eventually they'll get to this position to where the kettlebell's at the height that they wanna have it at. So a good way to kind of get this thing started is just a simple exercise called the hike, okay? So again, with all those things in mind, feet shoulder width apart. When I go to set up from this, again, thinking about a nice triangle position with this as well, I'm actually gonna reach out from my hinging position and allow the kettlebell to tilt back. From there, I'm gonna pack my shoulder blades down, right, to make sure that my lats are engaged. And then the first motion, keeping this good hinging position, is straight back and then a squeeze of the butt at the top. Right? Notice I'm not leaning back at the top. I'm squeezing my butt and sending my head straight to the ceiling at the top. Okay, so for us at Virtuous, what we like to see is the kettlebell to go at least forehead height. Obviously, you can take it a little higher if you would like, but as long as your feet are shoulder width apart, you're allowing that bell to swing right in the center of your triangle, and then you are squeezing your butt and sending your head up at the top, you're gonna pretty much make sure that you have a good kettlebell swing. So that's a simple short tutorial. Try it out in your workout today, and then we hope you enjoy it.